Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. So over here we are going to do this responsive navigation bar over here. Let's take a look. So you can make it smaller and the bottom navigation bar shows up, and you can make it larger, bottom navigation bar gets hidden and this one shows up, and at the same time you can navigate them. Of course you can navigate on mobile version as well, and this is our mobile version over here. So let's get started. Okay, first we'll go ahead and declare some screens over here. So these are some screens that we have. So we have four screens inside a list. So this, the first one is for home, the second container is for feed, the third one is for favorites, and the fourth one is for settings. So we have these four screens, and of course we'll access this four screen. These four screens would be accessed from our ONTAP event. That's why we have declared over here a variable which is called selected index. And right over here, this is our bottom navigation bar, and over here we have the selected index, the variable that we set up early at the top, and it's used as current index. And then whatever we tap, whatever the user tap, it takes the index and set it to the selected index, so we get the tapped index. And here we have these four bar items which relates to the screen list over here each time the user taps on a certain navigation bar. But let's run our app and see how it looks like for now. So this is what we have now. Now we want to click on them and navigate to each of the screens, the one that we have created over here. And for this reason, we'll come over here. So now we want to click on them and navigate to each of the screen over here, the screen that we have created. And for this reason, over here in the body section, we'll access them. So simply we'd do screens. So we'd do screens and we'll pass selected index. And with this, we are done with bottom navigation bar. As you can see, we can click on them and navigate to different page or screens. But this is not what we want. We want it to take the complete space of the screen. So for this reason, we are going to wrap this around inside a. So our pages are taking the whole screen. Now over here, we want to set up a vertical navigation bar. To be able to do that, over here we'll use navigation rail, and if you hover over on it, it has some required argument. One is selected index. Selected index will set the selected index that we declared at the top, and it requires more argument. So let's go ahead and use them. Now of course we have error. Now over here, this wants you to the screens that where you want to navigate to. Now we'll have these four destination items, or four items, just like bottom navigation bar. So let's go ahead and save them. Okay, now it's already looking better. So as you click on them, the bottom navigation bar works, but if you click on them, actually they don't work. The reason they don't work is that we have to set up this selected index as we tap on them, just like the bottom navigation bar. Now to be able to do that, we need to wrap this around inside called on destination selected. Of course, this is coming from navigation rail itself. This one is just like bottom navigation bar. As you click on them, it takes the index, and that index is set over there, and that index actually comes over here, and then that index becomes selected, and that is the active page. Actually, this is not what we want. This navigation bar we want to hide on mobile phone, and this is visible on mobile phone, and this is visible on desktop or browser, and this is hidden on browser. Now for this reason, we have to set up condition. Well, first we want to hide this on mobile phone, and to be able to do that, over here we'll set up a condition inside this list. Over here we are using media query. Now from media query we get the width, and we check if the width is more than 640 or not. If it is more than 640, we show this navigation rail, which means that we would be on desktop or larger screen. But if not, then it would be hidden. Let's save it. Now it's hidden because screen is not more than 640. So that's why this section is hidden over here. Now we're going to launch this on a browser. Now this has been launched on browser, as you can see. Now on browser we see that, but of course we can adjust our browser and we see that that's hidden. And if we make it larger, and that's visible. Now this time, what do you want to do? We want to hide this one. And for this reason over here, we want to set up another condition. Now for this one, we'll go ahead and copy the media query from here, and we'll put it right over here, and then we'll put this question mark, and after this bottom navigation bar over here we would do null. But of course we need to change the sign over here. So we'll show this bottom navigation bar only when it is less than 640. So let's go ahead and save it. So this is less than 640, so that's why we see that. And at the same time, we don't see this navigation rail over here, but let's enlarge it. Now you see that bottom navigation bar has gone. You make it smaller, the bottom navigation bar is here. Isn't it beautiful? Now let's check it on our mobile. So on our mobile, nothing changed. We have done a hot restart, but it's still there, okay? But of course, for navigation rail over here, this one, we could do a little more styling. Styling, we'll go inside this navigation rail over here, and right below this destination section, we'll put some new code. Over here, we have this label type and selected label index, selected label text style. What it means that, let's go ahead and save it. So as you see, our text gets selected and it changed the color. So that's what we are doing over here. And we also have unselected label text. That is the default one. And at the same time, over here, we set up a leading section using the column. Now this one over here, the column showing this icon.